YouTubers and saxophonists alike. Today we're going to do a special video on care and maintenance on your saxophone. I'm going to show you how to take apart the saxophone for cleaning purposes and then put it all back together. Since on a saxophone there are a ton of keys, you know, it can seem like a puzzle to put them all back together. But it's actually fairly simple on how to do that. Whatever you take off, you put back on in the same order. So let's begin. So the first thing we want to do is we want to remove the mouthpiece. We want to detach the neck. We want to take off the neck. And we'll set that aside for now. One recommendation, work in an area that has a cloth or something so it's padded so your saxophone isn't scratching anything or being scratched. That's just my preference. So, first things first, we're going to take a small Phillips head screwdriver. Actually, no, I'm sorry, flathead. And that's what we're going to use to take out some of these screws. So, the first thing we want to do is we're going to remove the side keys right here. And on my saxophone, they have two screws. They have one on each end. The longer a rod is, they won't put a pivot rod inside. They'll just put two screws. So you can tell, this is just two screws. This is a pivot rod. So we'll start by taking this out. And one thing to make sure you don't lose the screws, unscrew them just enough that the actual key can slide out. Don't actually take out the screw or else you might lose it. So there we go, there's one. And sometimes you don't even have to take out both of them. You can just take out one and then slide the key out. Like that. So set it aside, and then one thing I like to do is I like to screw the screws right back in, just so I don't lose them. Also another thing, before you take out a key, make sure you take out the spring, disengage the spring, and you might want to do that just right before you start doing that, you know, just do that to every key. All you have to do is simply push it off. Some of them have little slots. I'm not sure if you can see that. Some of them have slots. So all you have to do is pull them out of the slot. And we're just going to do that for a couple more. Alright, that should be sufficient. So the next side key. On this side key, what you have to do is you have to take it out from the valve on the side. So you have to slide it out and then pull it out. And that's how that comes out. And then the next thing, since this is a rod right here for this key, we're going to unthread it and then simply pull it out, and this is the rod, and then the key comes out. Now one thing to keep in mind is that if it's the first time you're ever taking apart your saxophone, these rods will be greasy, very 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 greasy, so I recommend keeping some tissues or paper towels and such nearby. So if you get your hands messy, you can take it out. I'm using a different grease on this. I'm using some key oil, which is clearish yellow rather than Vaseline, which is black on this. So I'm just going to continue taking out the side keys, and then we'll continue on from there. So be right back in a minute. Okay, so now that we've taken off all of the side keys, the saxophone shouldn't have any side keys right here, and these three holes should be clear. I don't have a side F sharp. If I did, I would have a fourth hole somewhere here open, and I wouldn't have the key down here. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take out the octave key, and this one, on this saxophone, there's a screw up here by the neck joint, and we're just going to unscrew that. And it's a pusher, and it's a rod, so you have to unscrew the rod until the end falls out, and then you can simply pull it out. One thing that helps during that is taking out the spring, disengaging the spring, and that helps the rod come out easier. And then remember to put the rod back with the piece so you don't lose the rod. And we'll set that aside. So the octave is done. Oh, and don't forget the little upper register octave. Now, I'm sure you're probably asking yourself right now, why would you take apart your saxophone when you can misalign the keys because of doing so? Well, you won't really misalign the keys because you're simply just taking out the part and you're not messing with the springs. The reason you would do that is you can't really clean a pad if it's on the saxophone. So you shouldn't do this very often. If you do this like once every 2 or 3 months, or once every year if you really don't play that much, and you can just give it a nice deep cleaning. Other than that, you just polish the outside and just leave it how it is. So that's the reason for taking it apart. So since I have key risers, I'm going to take these off. The next thing we're going to take out is the palm keys. I'm just going to set those aside. So these are usually held by rods. So we're going to undo the rod for this. And then if it helps, you can wiggle the key back and forth and the rod will come out. And then watch out for the springs, because the keys will jump. Okay, and we'll continue with the other two. Okay, so the octave keys are off. Now we're going to work on the side spatula keys. These are the low B flat, B, C sharp, and G sharp keys. So we're going to start up here, and you want to pay attention to which one goes where. So we're going to start with the low B flat, since this one is the bottom one. So we're going to see which one that's connected to. Oh, it's the same one as the G sharp. So we take off two keys. One half. Okay, there goes the low B flat. And then we'll work on low B. And the low C sharp is a tricky one, because it's a two-part piece. It's not directly connected to the C sharp key. It's a pivot hinge sort of thing. And you have to take off the key first before you take off the pin. So, as you see the linkage down here. So you must take off the key before you take off the pen. And we'll take off the spring and we'll slowly pull it up and out. There we go. And then all you're left with is the C sharp pad just left there. No spring, no nothing. And this is attached by a rod. Okay, now we can get to work on the main keys. And most of these are on a single rod. So on this one, the B, the bis, the C, are all on the same rod. So taking out one rod takes out all of those keys. But first, I have to take out my G, which is right above. So my G is on top of those. So I have to take that out first. Okay. And now, let me screw in this stuff. Okay, now, on my saxophone, what it has is it has a hole in one of the posts. It's just a blank hole, no screw goes there. And that's where the rod will go through when you pull it out. You can't angle it away from the post, so you have to go through the post. So when you do that, so now what you want to do is you want to first take out all the springs to all of the keys. As you pull the rod out, you want to wiggle the keys, and that will make the rod come out even. As you see, the rod is starting to pull out, and it's going to go through the post, through the hole in the post, and then it pulls out. And watch out, because as soon as you pull them out, all of them just come apart. Okay, so now what you want to do is you want to set these keys aside. You want to put them all together so you know that these are the keys that go on that rod. It's a pretty long rod. So now, what we can do is we can take off this front end. Okay, now we get to work on the bottom set of keys. And this is the same deal. I still have a hole in a post that I have to go through, and I have a rod that connects all of these keys together. Again, you want to disengage all of the springs by pulling them out. Once you do that, it should be easier to pull out the rod. If you leave the springs in, it causes tension on the keys, and then the rod will come out a lot more difficult. So now that all of the keys have come out, you just simply pull them out. And if, again, if this is your first time, you want to pay attention to where some of these go and how these linkages work. So you want to watch that. So we'll set that right over there, along with these keys. Okay, and now we only have three keys left. We have the side F sharp, we have the low C, and the low E flat. And these two, on this saxophone, my low C and my low E flat are both put on one rod. And this, basically one rod connects both of those keys together. And they pivot around the same rod. And then for these, what I want to do is I want to assemble them back in the when they're outside of the saxophone and put the rod back in so they can stay connected. And then finally, we have the side F sharp, which we can just unscrew on the top, take out the spring for it, and it's almost out. There we go. And there you go. That is all of the keys taken off of a saxophone. Pretty scary sight, huh? In the next video, or in the next videos, I'm going to show you how to put it back together after you've cleaned it. So, stick around.